This illustration is about a block is kept at rest supported by a rod. Here the figure shows a block A, which is of mass 10 kg, placed on a rough inclined plane with friction coefficient 1 by root 3. And here we are required to find minimum mass of rod B, so that block A does not slide on incline, and it is saying there is no friction between the top surface of block and rod. Now, in this situation, here first we draw the free body diagrams of block A and rod B. So, if we draw the free body diagram of A, here you can see along this incline, this A is placed, and downward it will experience its weight mg. And due to ground, it will experience a normal reaction N1. And due to the weight of rod B, it will experience another normal reaction N2 on it. And as it has a sliding tendency in downward direction, it will experience friction in backward direction. And just to keep it at rest, the value of friction must be mu N1. Here we can also draw the forces in the diagram. Like here you can see I'm drawing the diagram again. This is a rod B, this block A. Rod B is supported by a ledge which is fixed. Upper ledge is not having any contact with the rod B because due to weight it has a motion tendency in downward direction. So we can see here this is a normal reaction N1 acting on A due to ground. So on ground it will be N1 again. Between B and A, another pair of normal reaction N2 will be acting. And here the friction will act on A in backward direction. And B is also being supported by a normal reaction due to this ledge or a wall, NW we can call it. So if we draw the free body diagram of rod B, here in this equation we can draw it. If this is the reference line along and normal to the incline, then it is experiencing its weight mbg in downward direction, and a normal reaction N2 is acting on it normal to incline due to block A, and it is also being supported by a normal reaction Nw by this wall support. And in the situation, as this angle is 60 degrees, here we can take this angle as 60 degrees. And in this situation also this angle is 60 degrees. And we can write for limiting equilibrium of block A. Here we can use along inclined plane and normal to inclined plane all forces must be balanced. So here we can write N2 plus mg cos 60 degrees is equals to N1, and along the incline we can write mu N1 is equals to mg sin 60 degree. Similarly for rod B, we can balance the forces in normal to plane because along the plane this Nw will not be used over here. So here it can be written as N2 is equals to mbg cos 60 degree. As we have got the value of N2, if we place it over here, we get the value of N1, which we can substitute here, and this equation becomes mu times the value of N1 will be m plus mb multiplied by g, and it is cos 60, so we can write it 1 by 2 is equals to mg sin 60 degree, that is root 3 by 2. So here g also gets cancelled out, and simplifying this relation will get the value of mb, which we can see here is m multiplied by, it is root 3 and mu is also 1 by root 3, so it becomes 3, and this can be written as m multiplied by, this will be 3 minus 1. So this will be 2m, and the value of m we are given with 10 kg. So the value of mass of rod B we are getting is 20 kg. That is the final result of this problem, which is required to keep the block A in limiting equilibrium or at rest on the incline without a sliding.